I got the moves. I got the moves. I'm making moves. You gotta move.
You gotta
make the city move.
Like, whoa.
I make the city move. I got the move.
The Toronto Raptors are now entering a new era in their franchise after trading DeMar DeRozan for Kawhi Leonard. The team has been a title competing team for the last few years, but have never seemed to ever get it done, and this is probably the reason behind why they did the recent trade. But it really shouldn't have taken this long. Why? I'll be going over that in today's video. If you're new here and enjoy the video, be sure to subscribe for more NBA content. But with that being said, let's talk about how the Toronto Raptors could have been an NBA dynasty. It all starts back in the 2012 offseason, the offseason before the 2012-13 season. The Miami Heat just beat the Oklahoma City Thunder, and the Toronto Raptors were coming off a terrible season, only winning 23 games. DeMar DeRozan just had a pretty good season, averaging around 17 points per game. But clearly, there needed to be a change in Toronto. 20 wins a season wasn't going to cut it. So on July 5th, 2012, the Toronto Raptors traded for Kyle Lowry from the Houston Rockets. Kyle Lowry had been playing pretty well in Houston that prior season, averaging around 15 points a game, over 6.5 assists and 5 rebounds, and had decent shooting splits. With hindsight, this was a fantastic move by the Raptors. They won 34 games the next season and continued to improve on that, and even made the Eastern Conference Finals. But the Raptors could have done more than this. They could have been NBA champions. How? Well, whilst the Raptors were making some moves for Kyle Lowry, there was some disturbance down in the NBA runners-up locker room. The Oklahoma City Thunder were reluctant to give James Harden the money he wanted, and this in the end caused him to be traded to the Houston Rockets. But what has been going under the radar that no one talks about is the mistake the Raptors made. Before the Rockets and Thunder started any negotiations, the Raptors were actually offered a trade by the Thunder, which they denied. It looked a little bit like this. The Raptors would receive James Harden for Jonas Valanciunas, Terrence Ross, and Jose Calderon. As I mentioned, this trade was denied, and James Harden would end up going to the Rockets, and he would dominate there. He'd win MVP a few seasons later, and take the Rockets to multiple playoff appearances. But what if the Raptors knew about this potential? What if the Raptors agreed to this trade? Well, just like on the Rockets, Harden would have an immediate impact. Though he was a sixth man on the Thunder, he still had better stats and was an overall better player than Lowry, so Lowry becomes a sixth man on the Raptors, and James Harden and DeMar DeRozan dominate the front court. You might be saying, isn't Harden a shooting guard? And yes, that is true, but Harden was actually a point guard on the Thunder, and we've clearly seen he can play really well as a starting point guard. Just take a look at the 2016-17 NBA season. It's just crazy to imagine a Toronto Raptors backcourt of Harden and DeRozan with Lowry coming off the bench. Something like that is very scary. Harden makes an immediate impact on the Raptors in his first season there. He averages nearly 25 points a game, and DeRozan plays off him very well. With Harden and Lowry, the new look Raptors win 45 games and make the playoffs as a fifth seed. They would beat the Brooklyn Nets in the first round, but lose to LeBron James and the Heat in the second. In the 2013-14 season, the Raptors win 60 games and finish as the first seed in the East. Harden has yet another insanely dominant season, averaging 25 points per game again. DeRozan also has a great season, and so does Lowry. The team have great chemistry and are winning in the East. Toronto beat the Hawks in the first round of the playoffs and cruise past the Bulls in round 2. They then come up against the reigning champs, the Miami Heat, and surprise everyone and win that too. The Raptors then go to the finals and beat the Spurs, winning the franchise's first ever championship. But the Raptors don't slow down there. The next season, James Harden is an MVP candidate, and he helps take the Raptors to a 57-win season. The Raptors would then upset the Cavs with LeBron and make yet another NBA Finals. Without Harden, this team only made the Eastern Conference Finals, but now with him, they make it out of the East and play the Golden State Warriors, which they would end up beating in 7 hard-fought games. The Raptors would again dominate the next season, winning 58 games, but it was unfortunately not enough to topple the Cavs with LeBron James, so the 3-1 lead thing still happens, etc., and this means, unfortunately, KD still joins the Warriors, but we're focusing on the Raptors here, so let's take a look at next season. In the 2016-17 season, the Raptors' chances of more NBA Finals success rises, as they trade for Serge Ibaka from the Orlando Magic, except this time they trade Norman Powell there instead of Terrence Ross because, as we know, he's now on OKC. With James Harden having an MVP-worthy season, the Raptors finish atop the Eastern Conference with 53 games won. They manage to beat the Cavs and Celtics and make it all the way to the NBA Finals yet again, but unfortunately, fall to the stacked Warriors. And finally, we reach the final season of this interesting scenario. The Raptors have won 2 championships and have competed heavily over the last couple of seasons and gone on multiple deep playoff runs. In this year, the Raptors' main guy, James Harden, dominates and wins MVP, and the Raptors would go on to upset the Warriors in the finals in 6 games. And that concludes the scenario. Let me know what you guys think of it in the comments below. This is basically just an interesting what if I found, but I didn't want to make a 20 minute video out of it, so I just shortened it into this style of format. Let me know what you think of it below and tell me if I should do more. If you enjoyed the video, be sure to drop it a like and subscribe. But with that being said, I am out. Peace.
My mind state for like the crime in the summertime. Higher than average, lot of cabbage. Thank God I never abide by the established guidelines that keep niggas inside of fabrics. Commissioned by the state, I skate by the masters. Like Yoo-hoo with a new riding passenger. Shout out Oak Cliff, I'm about to fly to Dallas. Decade from now, I might just buy the Mavericks.